In this video, you will learn how to use Xlookup function for two different leads. In an earlier video, I explained Xlookup function with 5 practical examples. If you haven't watched that video, I put a link in here, and by clicking on that, you can watch the video. But this video takes the idea from the previous one to the next level. Are you ready for a new challenge? Let's go! We want to use Xlookup for two different lists. The first list belongs to the students of the Faculty of Engineering, and the second list belongs to the students of the Faculty of Foreign Languages. And in this list, we want to return the email address of some students from those two lists. Since we have two lists, the function is a little different. I type equal if error, and the value in this case gonna be xlookup function. So I type xlookup, and I'm looking for this value, comma. For the lookup array, you need to select the first list sheet and select this range. But if you have a long list, you can use the shortcut key. For selecting the range, first select the first cell, and then press Ctrl, Shift, and down arrow keys on the keyboard. Excel automatically select the entire range and press F4 to fix the range, comma. And for return array, we want to return the email address. So I select this range and press F4 and close the parentheses and add comma. The value if error section activates. And in this section, we need to add another if error function. For the value, again, we add another xlookup function. The lookup value is this cell, comma. And for the lookup array, this time we select the second list sheet, and we are looking for this range, and press F4, comma. For the return array, select the email address range, and press F4, and close the parentheses, and type comma. For the value if error, this time type quotation, not in the list, quotation, and close two parentheses and press enter. Now, if I drag it down, you can see the email address for different students. For example, Dexter Orozco is from the first list, and Kyron Blackwell is from the second list. And if I add my name to the list and drag the formula down, you can see that the not in the list appears. Maybe this function was a little confusing for you. Let me explain step by step what really happened. In the formula, first we have the if error function. If no error occurs, Excel calculates the first xlookup and searches for the result in the first list and executes the function. But if Excel couldn't find any match in the first list, it means that there is an error. So Excel starts the second if error function. This time again, if no error occurs, Excel calculates the second xlookup and searches for the result in the second list and executes the function. But if Excel couldn't find any match in the second list, it means the error happened again. And this time Excel shows the not in the list message and ends the function. If you think this video was useful, please like, comment, subscribe, and ring the notification bell. And I love you.